right, here we go again, guys. We're going to be doing a video. You guys like these videos. I've been getting some requests for more of the videos. We do this series, How to Destroy Atheism in a Debate Effortlessly and Easily Every Time. Sometimes we name it How to Destroy Atheism in a Debate Easily and Effortlessly Every Time. Now, I'm going to be switching freeways over here, so for about a minute we're going to be putt-putting along here as everyone merges. And wow, do I have something shocking to tell you what happened last night. This atheist went ballistic. He was very angry in the chat room because I defeated him in a debate. And I defeated him with one sentence. It was so good. Now, I have to tell you guys, before I tell you the one sentence that I defeated the atheist with, you know, we do love the atheist. We know that atheism's evil, but we do love the person that is stuck in the fictional worldview of atheism. So, one of the best ways to help people unbrainwash themselves so they realize atheism's a bunch of crapola is to show them the fallacies of atheism, of which there are many. Everything about atheism is a fallacy. So I'm going to point out to you, let's get the faster lane here, I'm going to point out to you some of the fallacies of atheism and why this atheist last night went nuts in the chat room when I defeated him in debate. Okay, and now before I get into this, did you hear the news that Christopher Hitchens is no longer a successful debater? He has been dethroned. He has really going downhill in his debating skills badly. I just think Christopher Hitchens' career is totally over. Hopefully he does what Peter Hitchens, his brother, did. You know, Peter Hitchens was an atheist, and Peter Hitchens, he too, like me, realized that atheism is full of crapola, and he left atheism for truth, life, salvation in Jesus Christ. I gotta get over in the right lane. This guy's in the military here, so let me speed up, because I think he's gotta get in the left lane. Now, before I start this video, click below, after it's done, I should say, at shockofgod.net. When you go there, click free stuff, and I got some free stuff there for you. But also on that page is the debate where Christopher Hitchens gets destroyed in debate. Literally destroyed. There's one part of the debate, he's stalling, so he dishonestly moves his microphone around and says, I don't think my microphone's working. And everyone's like, yeah, it's working. He gets destroyed in that debate. So Christopher Hitchens lost that debate horribly. I felt sorry for Christopher Hitchens, you know. He lost so bad. You got to check it out. Even the audience was laughing at him, how horrible he was doing. Right here below, shockofgod.net, and then click free stuff at the top of the page. Now, speaking of audience laughing at them, the guy last night, my chat room was laughing at him. If you go to the same website below and click chat room, you can go in there and you can see me poning atheist. And here's what happened last night. In this debate, I was showing the atheist that atheism contradicts itself badly. Now, it helped that there was a bunch of atheists in there contradicting each other. They actually helped me. And I asked all the Christians, do you believe God exists? This is what I asked the Christians. And this is what you can do with your atheist friends to show them that their worldview is null and void. If it contradicts itself, it's null and void, and atheism contradicts itself. So I asked my Christian chat room friends in there, I said, let me get over here real quick. I said, to the Christians, do you believe it's possible for God to exist? Do you believe God exists? For my atheist friends, I ask, do you believe it's possible for God to exist? Do you believe he exists? Now, what happened, this guy that was in there, an atheist, he got very upset at that question, and all the atheists started panicking. See, I asked the atheist, I said, well, wait a minute. And I took a little poll in the room. I said, look, which of the atheists in here agree that it's possible for God to exist? And a bunch of them said it's possible, right? And I said, which of you say it's impossible for God to exist, which totally contradicts what the other atheists are saying? And a bunch of them said it was impossible. And the ones saying it's possible were saying the other atheists were wrong. And the atheists saying it's impossible were saying the ones saying it's possible were wrong. They were having like a little feud in the chat room. Like Jesus said, a house divided against itself cannot stand. And atheism is a house divided. So, pick up the throttle a bit. So what happens is this. This guy in the room starts getting really ticked off, cussing at me and stuff. So I say, look, why don't you and I debate? So he kind of hemmed and hawed and evaded like atheists always do because they're afraid to debate. You guys know the amazing atheist is afraid to debate me. Same thing with the thinking atheist. They're like afraid. I challenge them. They don't want to do it. Same thing with Penn Jillette. The Penn and Teller, you know, that Penn Jillette guy. All three of them, they're like afraid to debate. But this atheist, like, finally, because I put him on the spot in the room, he's like, okay, I'll debate. So I ask him this, do you believe it's possible for God to exist or impossible, or you don't know? See, there's no other option. If he says it's possible, fine. If he says it's impossible, fine. If he says he doesn't know, fine. So he says, well, I don't know. He doesn't know, right? Yet he just said it was possible. Now he's saying he doesn't know. He even contradicted himself. So I said, well, then if you claim you don't know if God exists or not, and you're saying you don't know, are you an atheist or an agnostic? He said he's an atheist. He swore up and down he's an atheist. Fine. I then asked him, do you see that atheists say it's possible for God to exist and impossible? He said, yeah, they both say that. I go, do you agree then that atheism contradicts itself since it makes the claim and accepts people like you that claim it's possible for God to exist and also impossible? Aren't those two contradictory claims? They're not differences of opinion only. They downright contradict each other. I go, are you willing? Look at this guy going in the left lane, hitting all that debris. What's he doing? I go, are you willing to admit that atheism contradicts itself? And he says, yes, it does contradict itself. Atheism contradicts itself. It makes the claim it's possible for God to exist and also impossible. He went ballistic because I showed him how full of crapola atheism is. Look, any worldview that has an internal contradiction like atheism does, guys, it's null and void. It cannot be true. Logically, it cannot be true. How could something be possible and impossible at the same time? Yet these atheists, all in the room, they're saying they're atheists, not agnostics. They're claiming it's possible and impossible for God to exist at the same time. Therefore, they represent atheism. They are atheism. And atheism, therefore, contradicts itself, making it null and void. So the guy gets on and he goes, well, I want to ask you a question. And he talks about Christianity and Islam. Do they contradict each other? I said, of course. But they're two different religions, you dodo bird. Christianity is not Islam, and Islam is not Christianity. So I said, of course, now you're getting it. But then I asked him, and this is how I defeated him in the debate with one sentence. I asked him this. I said, look, do all Christians say God exists? He said, well, yes. I said, you just lost the debate. Christianity says God exists. All Christians say God exists. If we said God didn't exist, we'd be atheists. So I go, you see, there's no inconsistency there. The Christians say God exists. But you atheists say, no, it's impossible for God to exist, but it's also possible. You see the contradiction, and everyone agreed with me that the atheist worldview contradicts each other. Logically, let's say you weren't a Christian, right? Logically, it can be possible that Christianity is true. I believe it's true. But let's say you're in a debate and you're making the claim that Christianity is true. You can prove it to be true because it's consistent. It doesn't have this internal inconsistency where it contradicts itself like atheism does. Atheism says it's possible for God to exist and also impossible. Therefore, it is null and void. If you're an atheist watching this video, I really have to ask you, what happened to your rational thinking skills? What happened to your critical thinking skills? How could you be involved with the worldview? I saw this piece of plastic. I thought it was something flying out to hit me from this car. How could you? The show must go on. Let me continue. Hey, look, this is where it picks up good speed. I like this part. How could you be in a worldview that contradicts itself and says it's impossible for God to exist, yet it's possible? It's just stupid. Let me cut in front of this guy here. Atheism is stupid. It's so stupid when you think about it. Oh, back to how I destroyed the atheist arguments and debates. Then what I did was this. He said, yes, Christians do claim God exists. All of them claim God exists. So I said, do you agree that there is no inconsistency? All Christians say God exists. He said, well, yes. I said, okay, thanks. I just won the debate. But atheism contradicts itself. It says it's possible for God to exist. It also says it's impossible. The atheists started cussing at me. They were so upset. The guy that I was talking to, he was going ballistic. Now, I want you guys to do this. I want you, if you have any atheist friends, I want you to go through this with them, and I want you to see how they're like the person that finds out there's no Santa Claus. And we all know that Santa syndrome is real. By the way, make sure you look up the video Santa Syndrome, because Santa syndrome is a real powerful cause for atheism. Matter of fact, click below this video. I'm going to explain what Santa syndrome is, because all the atheists are obsessed with Santa Claus. Let me not hit this thing here. Try this with your atheist friends next time. Here, now go through this with me. Try it and then post down below how it worked, okay? It works great. Atheists will finally admit to you that atheism does contradict itself. If it contradicts itself, it's null and void. N-U-L-L and void. Here's what you say real quick, and I gotta hurry because I only got like a minute. You tell your atheist friends, let's say you got a house and there's 666 atheists there. 666 atheists. 333 of the atheists, no! The horse camper got in front of me. 333 atheists in the room say it's possible for God to exist, and another 333, half of them, say it's impossible. Then you ask your atheist friend, are they all atheists? Well, yeah, they're all atheists, trust me. Then you say, are they making contradictory claims? They say, yeah. Then you ask them, well, then atheism contradicts itself because they all represent atheism. Atheism accepts the two contradictory claims. And they will admit to you that, yes, atheism contradicts itself. Atheism, you lose. Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. It's game over. Have a great week. This is Shock.